I'm Denise Cooper. I founded the InnerSource Commons, and I'm a longtime open source activist. And I'm also newly a vice president of special initiatives for a company called Nearform.
I am Georg Rütter. I work as an InnerSource evangelist at Robert Bosch in Germany, and I happen to be a trusted committer for a long time.
In this section, we're going to introduce you to the role of trusted committer. So at the beginning, I'd like to say that you can think of a trusted committer as a really key role in any InnerSource team. Trusted committers are the ones that hold the quality of the product and also the interactions with contributors in their hands. And it's their job to mentor contribution, to make sure that contributions make it across the finish line and actually get merged into product. And they also hold the good of the community. It's one of the strongest advocacy positions in a working InnerSource community.
And as a trusted committer, the role is defined more by the responsibilities that you have than by the privileges that you enjoy. And as a trusted committer, you represent the interests of both the software that you're building and the community that is building the software. So you'll have both tech-oriented and community-oriented responsibilities, and we'll explore both of these angles in the following segments.
So before we go into the details of what a trusted committer actually does, let's spend some time contrasting that role with other roles in InnerSource on a high level of abstraction to explain why we think the name is both apt and important. Let's start with a contributor. So as the name implies, a contributor contributes to a project. They contribute code, but also non-code artifacts like bug reports and feature requests and even documentation. The contributor might not be part of the community as represented by the circle in the slide. They might be sent by another team to develop a feature that the team needs. This is why we refer to contributors sometimes as guests or being part of a guest team. The contributor is expected to fit in and conform to the community's expectations and process.
The trusted committer, on the other hand, is always a member of the InnerSource community. And they are sometimes referred to as the host. And in this analogy, they are the ones who set the house rules and sort of make their guests comfortable and make sure that they can work together efficiently. And compared to contributors, they have earned the responsibility to push code closer to production. And they're generally allowed to perform tasks that have a higher level of risk associated with them.
The product owner is the third role in InnerSource. Similar to an agile process, the product owner is responsible for defining and prioritizing requirements and stories for the community to implement. The product owner regularly interacts a lot with the trusted committer, making sure that requests or contributed features actually belong in the product. Especially in smaller grassroots type InnerSource communities like the one Georg works in, the trusted committer also acts as the product owner. Please check out our product owner learning path video for more detailed information on this role.
The trusted committer role is present in any InnerSource community. They might not just call it that. In fact, in my community, we called that role maintainer. But it turns out that GitHub, for instance, has this role as a technical role in their product. So there's a conflict there. We could have also called it committer. But again, the Apache communities, they have a role committer. And that is mostly tech-oriented and has fewer responsibilities than the trusted committer. Because the trusted committer has also the community-related responsibilities, which goes far beyond what Apache attaches to their committer. And we chose to use the term trusted because as a trusted committer, you're building on the trust and the empowerment that both your management and your community places in you to do your job. And finally, by fostering openness and transparency, the trusted committers build trust both in the process of building the product and in the quality of the product itself.
So just as when you're writing software, how you choose names is important, it's important in InnerSource as well. And if you use the correct name and hold that space of trusted committer, you impart into your InnerSource program, you know, a feeling for that role and consistency across your whole community.
So now you should have a basic understanding of the role of the trusted committer, why the name is important, and also what other InnerSource roles the trusted committer interacts with. In the following segments, we'll go into the responsibilities of trusted committers in more detail, specifically their role to ensure product quality, up-leveling their community, lowering barriers to making contributions, advocating for the community's needs, And also, we're going to look at how to become a trusted committer and what it takes to fill that role.